This is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. And where I am today, I'm here in Las Vegas, Nevada, just a few miles from downtown, which is famous downtown Las Vegas, where you can be gambling, and it's called Sin City here in Vegas, for those of you guys that don't know. And actually, every Friday, there's a farmer's market in downtown Las Vegas, actually at the old bus station. And I would encourage you guys to go there. It's probably one of the best farmers markets in Las Vegas, but it does not compare to the farmers markets in California by any means, unfortunately. But where I'm at today, I'm just a few miles from that location, and I'm here to visit one of the farmers that actually sells at the Las Vegas downtown farmers markets. It's Sin City Farms. And Sin City Farms, actually, the owner is one of my viewers. He watches me, he comments on some of my videos and all that stuff, and that's how I found him. And he has his own YouTube channel. I'll post a link down below so you can learn more about what he's doing, what he's growing here in Las Vegas. And in this episode, what I want to do is I want to take you guys around to his farm, where he's growing literally in a residential neighborhood. You'd never know by looking at the front of his house that behind his house he's growing literally hundreds of baby plants to grow food for restaurants as well as individuals here in Las Vegas. And you know, right now it's August and we're going through the peak of the heat. It's cooling down a little bit, but probably gonna get a little bit hotter later this week. It's been over 100 degrees here for, you know, pretty much the last month or two, and it's hot here. But despite that fact, he's still growing his farm in Las Vegas, and he's doing it a lot different than I've ever seen before, right? So he's modeling another popular YouTuber who I actually had on my show previously, Curtis Stone. I'll put a link down below to the video I did with Curtis, where basically Curtis is using other people's property to make a farm and to grow food for the people there in Canada where he lives, right? And Canada is a way different climate than here in Las Vegas, right? So some of the techniques Curtis teaches may not work exactly here in Las Vegas, but the farmer here has figured out some ways to do that kind of model and grow things like some root crops as well as baby greens to make a living. And actually, so much of a living, he actually left his job to get into farming here in Las Vegas. Now, that's not necessarily the first thing I do. I might want to grow in a place more conducive to growing than Las Vegas, but nonetheless, Las Vegas, you know, needs people like Roman here to grow food, to show people it is possible, and also to provide restaurants and locals here some of the best food, because unfortunately there's not enough people growing food here in Las Vegas. So anytime I have the opportunity to come out to show you guys a farm, show you guys a garden on how people are doing it, so that you guys could model it, you guys could do it also, or even just to inspire you guys, I'm all there. So anyways, let's go ahead into the backyard and show you guys what's growing on. So now I'm about to enter the backyard of Sin City Farms to show you guys what's growing on. Before I do, I want to point out this tree right here. I don't know if you guys can see that, but basically it's an olive tree, and it's a fruiting olive tree. Olives grow great here in Las Vegas, and I personally believe somebody should start an olive farm to grow Las Vegas olives. They grow really well. And you know, olives can be cured. They're actually one of my favorite foods. I don't like consuming olive oil, but I love consuming the whole olive that contains not only the oil, but also phytonutrients and phytochemicals, as well as vitamins and minerals. Anyways, Roman here, I don't think is utilizing the olives at this point, but hopefully he will in the future. But what he is doing is incredible in his backyard. And I wanna let you guys know that, you know, if you guys are looking to buy a house, buy a property, strongly encourage you guys to get a property with a large lot so you have the most amount of space to grow food. And he's done that here. He has a nice corner lot, which generally has a lot more space to grow food than, you know, standard lots. All right, let's head in the backyard and show you guys what's happening. So this is the backyard full of plants that's growing. And Roman focuses on growing the baby greens, because basically he could let them grow for, depending on what kind of green he's growing, a couple weeks, maybe 21 days, 30 days, and then he could basically cut them, and this is from seed, cut them, harvest them, sell the greens, and he basically, then the greens will grow again, and then he could basically let them grow another week or so, cut them again, and then sell the greens again. So his main crop that he sells at the farmer's market is actually just bags of cut greens that he sells, like for a, for a good price, actually. You know, it's quite expensive to buy greens grown here in Las Vegas, and actually, it's actually quite rare because not many people do it. And you know, in the summertime, July, August, you know, even end of June, one of the things I strive not to do is have any baby plants in my garden, right? Baby plants are really delicate and fragile and may succumb to the 100 plus degree weather very easily. But using the techniques that he's using, he's getting some amazing growth. And one of the special techniques he's using is he put up a shade cloth here to help shade some of the tender baby greens from the full sun. You know, I strive to buy, you know, plant starts that are already established, that are already healthy, that have been growing for a while, and then plant in my garden because they have a much easier time of actually succeeding and taking off. So if you're new into gardening and you're just starting to garden in the desert, I'd probably recommend starting off with some good healthy plant starts from a nursery near you instead of starting by seed. But as you guys will learn in this episode, there are some seeds that even in full sun will grow quite easy. So I'm glad he's here doing this research, even growing things like lettuce in the middle of 110 degree weather. You know, I wouldn't do that. So he could learn what works and what doesn't. So more knowledge could be known about what grows in the hot desert in the summer. And despite the hot weather challenges, he's growing lots of stuff and doing fairly well at it. I think the first thing I want to cover is actually some of the supplementary crops that he's growing besides his greens. He really focuses on his baby leafy greens because basically for like 4 ounces, he sells for, I don't know, $4 or $5 or something like that. So it's a really good margin crop because you don't have to grow a lot to get a lot of money. Whereas, you know, you could grow other kinds of crops and they might not make you as much money. But I want to show you guys some of the other crops that he's growing that are more, you know, not cut and come again, that actually he plants once and they keep growing, to show you guys what he has grown on here. So here's a row of crops that he's growing in his garden. And first, he's got some eggplant, he's got a bunch of peppers and some tomatoes. He's got some sweet 100 tomatoes, a variety of peppers, including some hot peppers and some eggplant. And these are fairly good crops to grow. They're fairly easy. The eggplant is probably one of the easiest things to grow here in Vegas. And likewise, these guys are doing great. He's gonna be harvesting some eggplants to sell this week at the farmer's market. He's got a bunch of peppers that are, you know, flowering and fruiting fairly well. They do have some challenges with the aphids that I showed him and talked to him about how to deal with. Basically, I recommended spraying some high pressure water to blast off the aphids and do that repeatedly. Generally, he doesn't like to spray anything here, and he's growing all using organic methods. And so then I guess if that didn't work, spraying the water, then I'd maybe come in with some neem and Dr. Bronner's. And even more so than the aphids, he's having some ant challenges, which I got bit by some of the ants here. They're kind of a pain in the butt. But the ants are farming the aphids, so it's kind of a reoccurring problem. But at the same time, ants in some ways are beneficial because they're also spreading the pollen, you know, between the plants as well. But in general, I would try to reduce the amount of aphids and ants on the plants, because in general, it's probably not a good thing to have them have too many of them. And then at the end, he has some tomatoes that he left over. He had some other tomato plants that he pulled up because he was having some challenges with them. And that's the thing here in the desert, you know, not everything you plant is always going to make it. And that's all right if things don't make it, right? If things don't make it, guess what? You pull it up, compost it, get rid of it, and then start new. And that's actually what he's done. So he's constantly on a cycle of always, hey, what can I pull out next? What can I replant? New stuff. So his garden is always looking great, right? And if I stay on top of my garden, if I'm home at one time for a good amount of time, you know, I'm always there to do maintenance, pull out the things that aren't looking good and add new stuff. And that's why my garden always looks good. Plus, I choose the varieties of plants that are going to do better than others. Especially here in the desert, you need to grow certain varieties of plants to have, you know, the highest level of success. So next, I want to take you guys to another side of the garden where he's actually growing some of these plants. So on this side of the garden, which is actually in full sun, he's growing a few things. Number one, he's got basically beets that he's growing, not for the beetroot, but for the beet greens, because that is one of the greens that goes into his greens mix that he offers. And he says by far the beets are probably some of the easiest things, the beet greens are easiest things to grow here in the middle of the summer, even in direct sun, 100 plus degree weather. So that's actually really cool. You know, I don't grow necessarily beets for the greens, I grow them for the roots. And during the summer, actually, I find that I grow heirloom sugar beets, actually. And I harvest the greens and eat them, and they grow really well. And plus, at the end of the season, I have the nice big roots to eat. But aside from that, he's also growing the Malabar spinach in this area. Maybe we had a little bit of, maybe not so much compost that he spread down on this side, so it's might not grown as good as like the back side over there. You could see some of the plants started growing, but then they didn't really erupt or start growing faster. And the ones further on down are growing significantly better. And this is the difference the soil could make. Unfortunately, here in Las Vegas, the soil is very poor, doesn't have a lot of organic matter, and organic matter is really important for the microbes in the soil to thrive, to get that going. So he has been bringing in basically 1 cubic yard of compost for basically every 3 beds that he makes. And the other cool thing about Roman is that he's never farmed or gardened before until about 3 months ago here in Las Vegas, where basically he just decided to start a career in farming instead of his previous job. And I'll be sure to ask him more about that when I get to interview him. So I think especially for somebody that just started, what, March, April, May, June, July, August, literally 6 months ago, this is totally amazing. He's done totally an amazing job in just 6 months, from basically not growing to a full-on farm that he's deriving an income from. Now, another plant that he's growing that does quite well here in the desert is the watermelon. And here's a nice little, ooh, that one's ripe, a baby watermelon he's growing. This is another crop that the watermelon is like originally, I believe, from Africa. Africa, it's quite hot over there. And you know, so growing crops that are acclimated to this climate is the best thing to do, because then you're not having to fight the heat with things like shade cloth. You could grow them in full sun. You know, likewise, the Malabar spinach that he's growing in the far row, you can see it's really taken off. Some of the ones that are grown in a, you know, the better soil that has nutrition, they're like, you know, some are pushing 2 feet tall now, and they definitely need to be trellised up because they want to vine and grow out. Malabar spinach is one of the best greens to grow in the summer here in Las Vegas and can produce a lot. And so I believe he should be, you know, starting to harvest baby leaves and leaves to put into his green mix to give people new textures and also new nutrients, right? And also the tips on the Malabar can also be clipped and eaten. They're quite delicious, and they have a nice red color to brighten up some of his mixtures he's selling. And the other thing I want to tell you guys about Malabar spinach is that it's off to a slow start. So you can see some of these guys, I mean, they're barely like 2 inches out of the ground, right? As they pop out of the ground, they grow super slow. Don't be alarmed, they're getting established. You know, another couple weeks, you know, then they're gonna be established, and then they're literally gonna be growing like an inch or two or more a day. So don't be alarmed when your Malabar spinach starts off a little bit slow. You know, that's just kind of like their nature. And now, you know, some of the other things that I recommend for him, besides growing these cut and come again greens, which is his focus, is to grow other crops that are gonna do well in the nice summer heat here. Some that are gonna do really good, and he could literally establish, you know, like a bed of certain greens that he could plant once, and then he'll have them all summer basically to be harvesting from. So things like the Egyptian spinach works really well. That should be established early, and they're kind of like off to a slow start, kind of like the Malabar spinach. But once you got them growing, they're really growing fast. The tips could be eaten. Second thing that'd be good to grow would be something like the longevity spinach or the Gynera procumbens. Another excellent one to grow. Another one that'd be really good to grow is the water spinach. That also loves the heat. Another green or herb I would recommend is the papalo, as well as the shiso. Those have done amazing in my garden, and he could actually use those greens in an herb mix or to mix in with his other baby greens that he's growing. What I want to do next, before it actually gets too dark, is actually take you guys over to his main shaded area to share with you guys some of the greens he's growing here, and actually more specifically, how he's doing it. So now I'm in the main part of his garden, which is his basically baby greens production area. This is where he has all the different greens growing. Right in front of me here, we have the red Russian kale. Behind me here, we have beet greens. We have some different kinds of lettuces that he's growing. And then I think we have some more kale. And then we have some arugula and amaranth growing in the back there. And basically all these are in different stages. He'll have a certain area that he just planted, certain area, like this area here is an area that he's currently harvesting, another area that he's actually just seeded, and little baby seedlings are starting to emerge. So because he has these in all different stages, he's always having to do something and harvest something, right? So doing the babies are kind of a lot of work. The other thing that he's doing here that's a little bit different than any farmer I've seen, you know, is actually he's doing overhead watering, and generally he overhead waters once a day, depending on what time of the year it is. He might do that earlier in the day or later in the day. This time of year, for example, he's actually just overhead watering once a day, and you know, he says that his plants do fine because his plants get used to the one time a day watering, right? And if you started eating one meal a day, you'd probably get used to that too, and you'd probably be all right with it, right? And so it's very interesting to me that he's doing this, watering only once, and doing overhead watering, which people say no, but actually after looking at it and actually after thinking about it, for the method of gardening and for what he's growing, I would agree that overhead watering is probably the best technique. Now, you know, he has big sprinklers that come off and water big sections. I might want to control that a little bit more and might do like micro sprinklers to sprinkle each area. But nonetheless, you know, for different kinds of irrigation, you know, he's doing the best for this style growing. Some of his row crops, like the watermelon and Malabar spinach, you know, that might be a good area to put drip systems in, because you're not growing all these microgreens with really shallow roots. Those plants tend to get deeper roots and are gonna be there pretty much for a longer period of time than the cut and come again greens that he's growing. Then the next thing I wanna do is show you guys something that I encourage people never to plant in the summertime in Vegas, but he's actually doing it successfully. So one of the crops I really don't recommend people grow in Las Vegas in the middle of the summer like he's doing here is lettuce. So he's got like standard green lettuce. He also has got some red lettuce. Basically, when you plant the lettuce, they want to bolt really fast because it's just so hot out here. I guess the one exception would be tropical lettuce if you could find the special seeds. I'm experimenting this year with some tropical lettuce I got from Southwest Florida, where it is really hot and they're starting to grow, so hopefully I get some seeds from them and I can see how they're doing. But the lettuce wants to bolt really fast, and you know, for him, that's a good thing because it grows really fast, and then as it gets pretty tall, pretty much like this, he'll cut it back. So then it doesn't have any chance to bolt, and he'll get several cuttings off of this. He'll cut it, let it grow another week or so, they'll be back about this size, he'll cut it again, let it keep coming back. And in that instance, you know, he will be successful at growing lettuce. But if you're trying to get a nice big head of lettuce, that ain't gonna work. So actually this is kind of cool, and he's learned that actually some of the red lettuces do a little bit better than the green ones that are like right behind that are actually already bolting. And you know, I believe that is because of the pigments in the lettuce, right? The deep, rich red colors and the pigments are kind of like, you know, if you have more melanin in your skin and have a darker color skin, right? You're not gonna sunburn as easy, you know, if you have a dark skin versus somebody that's a white skin, right? And so the deeper, richer color lettuces could handle the sun more. And that's what he's found out. And then besides the lettuce, of course, he has some basil growing, which is also a really good crop to grow for the full season. You know, basil, as well as other family of plants in the mint family, basil, mint, and the shiso that I like so much, grow really well and can be grown easily in full sun. Now, the amazing thing here in his garden is that basically he's been growing 6 months, and he basically spread down the Rejuvenate from a local Vera Grow, which they say is you know, no biosolids in there. And he's been growing in this soil, and basically the only thing he's done aside from bringing in that soil and maybe putting in some worm castings is nothing. And so, you know, some of his growth, you know, in my opinion, based on gardens I've seen and me myself growing here, could be better. And so what I would recommend for him and for you guys out there too, if you guys are growing and things just aren't growing fast enough, and especially for him, you know, the faster the food grows, the more he could harvest, the more he could sell, and the more people of Las Vegas and the more restaurants he could serve and feed people local food instead of food that has to be trucked in, you know, from California to be sold here. So it's a lot fresher, it's gonna be a lot better tasting. And so for that, I would recommend and encourage him to maybe do like compost tea minimum once a week to kind of invigorate the soil and jumpstart the soil. I'd also encourage him to add something like rock dust, which is available really inexpensive here in Las Vegas at the IFA feed store at Martin and Dean Martin. I do have an episode where I go there and buy the rock dust or the azomite. Super inexpensive. It's like $16 or something for a 44-pound bag. There's no excuse not to add some of that in. And you know, because this is a new soil, new raised bed garden, I'd probably put like 1 pound per 1 square foot. And if that's too much for you, do like, I don't know, do 1 pound for 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 square feet, right? So just with a 44-pound bag, you know, he could do like three rows and just get that in there to grow more nutritious food, create more resilience in the food you're growing. You know, when the plants and the roots have all the nutrients in the soil they need, they're going to be healthier and there's going to be less pest pressures. They're also going to be able to grow faster. Another really down and dirty tip I would recommend for him is start to use some kind of fish hydrolysate. I've been using this year the Pure Protein fish hydrolysate. I'll put a link down below for a video I did about that. And you know, literally that made my plants grow so much faster than normal. So I would alternate like maybe Pure Protein maybe once every other week and then do the compost tea like every week just to get things growing a little bit faster and also enrich the soil and also of course add the rock dust. And the other thing I do is actually I start adding in and seeding in worms. So I try to get worm castings with the worm eggs in there and even some worms and put these in the beds so the worms could be your worker bees or your worker worms and they could start aerating the soil for you so that the soil doesn't have to be turned after every session of growing plants. So the last thing I'm going to do before I go in, because it's getting a little dark to film, is show you guys a few more tips that they're doing here. Number one is I like what they're doing for mulch. So I don't know if you guys could see that, but basically they got these big palm fronds that they basically just laid down on the ground so the ground doesn't get muddy, so they don't track mud into the house. This is an amazing use of the palm fronds. I wish more people would do this. You know, one of the challenges I see here is in between the rows, like the pathways. I mean, I thought I was skimpy with my pathways. Some of my pathways are like this much. His walkways are like this much, I swear, like 6 inches. So he's really maximizing his space to grow, but at the same time, you know, you got to almost balance so you don't step on the beds. So I would personally like mulch in between the pathways, whether that's with something like wood chips, or if you could get a nice shredder and shred up some of the palm fronds. I think that would be an excellent idea to mulch in between there to retain some moisture. Also, you know, try to keep your feet more clean. So the last part of this episode, what I want to do is actually I want to sit down and ask Roman, the farmer here, some questions about growing here in Las Vegas, why he decided to do this, and why, you know, you guys might want to quit your job and start a farm too. So now I have the pleasure of interviewing the farmer here, Roman of Sin City Farms. And is it true, Roman, that you actually quit your job so you could start farming here in Las Vegas?
I did. I had an opportunity to do this, so I went ahead and did this. I was going to do this regardless. We wanted to move to another state and do this, but this worked out, and it's blowing up.
Wow.
Yes.
That's great. I'm glad you're here in Las Vegas to do the farming like you're doing it, because nobody else that I know of has done it like this. And, you know, I mean, you're learning that some things work really well and some things don't work so good.
Exactly.
So what do you want to share with my viewers of something that really worked well that you think everybody who lives in Vegas should do this?
Well, I'm telling you, I was surprised at how well lettuce did under the shade cloth. So I think if you're going to be growing out here and you want to do leafy greens during the summer, get a shade cloth. I have 50% right now, and it's working great. So lettuce does really well in the summer out here.
But Eve, that's only because you're growing it, and then you're cutting it. You're not letting it go bolt, because if there's a point where the plant will grow, and then it's like, oh, it's too hot, I'm going to bolt. But you cut it way before that, and then it just comes again, right?
Exactly. It lasts a long time.
How long has your lettuce plants lasted?
I was surprised. I thought it was going to bolt a lot sooner. I'm looking right now about 4 months.
You could keep a lettuce plant alive 4 months in 100 degree weather.
Unreal, right?
Wow, that's amazing. Who would have knew? Because nobody really ever tried. Everybody always tries it to grow it to the nice lettuce head, but he's not doing that. He's just growing it for the baby greens.
Love it. And they're so healthy for you. You know, just like a microgreen, you know, they're very compact and they just have that nutrition inside of them.
Cool.
At a much smaller density.
So, not underneath shade cloth, what's your best green you're growing?
Yes, the beet greens are doing really well, and Curtis Stone gave me that little tip. So yeah, I like the beet greens, and I think the color is really good in my mix as well. So I think the beet greens really did, they just overtook. The bugs, I didn't have any bug pressure, so that helped a lot, you know. So they kept me alive during the summer.
Yeah, so I mean, the other thing that's amazing about Roman here is that he only started like 6 months ago. So is it true, Roman, that you literally never gardened or farmed before until 6 months ago in March when you started?
It was, yeah, I was doing little farming. I would probably say I was, you know, pots and just little tiny things here, pepper plants here and there, but not on this scale, no way. And I just wanted to do this, and I had this drive in me, and I really wanted to bring healthy food to people out here that you can't grow it out here, or we don't have food that's growing out here. So it's just amazing that you can do this, and that's really what my purpose is, to try and teach people that, and I invite people to come over.
Wow, that's cool. Yeah, I mean, another thing I like about it is farmers, and hey, I just emailed them the other day or messaged them, DM'd them, and he said, yeah, John, come on over. And you know, he already has a YouTube channel, so that's how I learned about him. I saw, like, oh, Sin City Farming, what's that? I clicked on his YouTube channel. I've been watching some of his videos for a while, and I was like, wow, I'm pretty impressed. This guy's doing pretty good. He's doing a lot differently than I am, and that's all right, because you know, as no matter how you're growing food, as long as you're growing food, and actually I'm glad for what Roman is doing here, because he's pushing the envelope of what is possible, because like, I would never in my right mind want to do what he's doing, because it's too much work. I just like to plant my plant and let it grow and put my irrigation on and everything's automatic. He's out here like doing stuff every day, taking care, replanting and all this kind of stuff. So I'm glad you're here doing this and have an open door policy. That's really important, you know, for me, and to spread the knowledge. And likewise, you know, Roman's able to do this here in Las Vegas, 100 plus degree weather. And I know some of you guys are watching this right now. You've always had in the back of your mind, you want to start something, or even just start a backyard garden, not even a farm, like to the scale that he's doing it. You guys could totally do it, because if he could do it in Vegas, you guys could do it anywhere, right? And I mean, this is probably one of the hardest places to grow, you know, aside from Phoenix and some other places that even get hotter than here. So, Roman, what's some of the one of the things that you've learned along this process that you would want to share with my viewers to maybe help them out too?
Yes, I mean, definitely keep it on a smaller scale if you want to start with something like this. And that's why primarily I'm doing this, is keeping it really small. I don't want to expand like there is that spin farming to where you go to other people's land and farm on their land, like neighbors. And I actually have a neighbor that wants me to farm his land, but I just want to keep a really small scale for now and then expand off of that if I do have a larger parcel in the future.
Yeah, I think it's really good to experiment and not bite off more than you could chew, like some dogs could do sometimes. And you know, that's why I started, like, you know, Roman started. He started with one area, then he expanded to another area, then he went to another area. And like my backyard garden here, I started with 4 raised beds. I went to like 16, I went to 20, I went to 25, then I converted my whole yard, right? So in stages. And as you grow, you'll learn more and you'll feel more comfortable. So another thing I want to talk about, Roman, is how did people accept you, you know, when you started coming to the farmer's market? Because I'll tell you guys, I'll be the first to say, the farmers markets here in Las Vegas are pretty pitiful. There's very few local growers. Like, most of the stuff is actually being imported from California. Although it's at a, you know, Las Vegas farmers market, most of the stuff's imported. So there's like literally less than a handful of growers at each farmers market that I go to that actually really truly grow here. And how did people accept you, or what did they say when you said, hey, I'm growing lettuce in the middle of summer? Did people think like you're trying to scam them?
Yeah, exactly. They think I'm bringing in, like, I'm going to buy it at Costco.
And then well, some people have been known to do that actually at our farmers markets. It's quite sad.
Whoa.
I won't say who, but anyways. But so you got to be careful. So it's important to have an open door policy. You guys saw in the video all the stuff he's growing, and you see on his videos what he's growing.
Absolutely. And it's important for me to, you know, grow and sell, because I want that nutrition that's locally based nutrition. I think that, you know, when you have locally based anything, you know, honey, you know, you can definitely benefit from those nutritions.
Yeah, and the other thing I want to talk about is when you harvest to go to market, Roman. So the farmers market's on Fridays here in Las Vegas, downtown. When do you harvest the food to take there?
Yes, it's usually the evening before. I might do an afternoon harvest, and I use my Quick Greens harvester. Works great out here. And I bag everything. I put it in this small fridge back here. This is my post-harvest room. And then it goes in the larger fridge in the refrigerator in the garage. So it works out well. I mean, I could fit a lot of stuff in there for my chef and for the farmer's market, and it works out great. And I swear, everybody wants me to come to their farmer's market. They want to say that I'm their local farmer, because nobody's doing this.
Yeah, it's quite sad, and I would encourage you guys, if you guys live in Vegas, start a farm. It's not that hard, right? You could learn from Roman. There's many different classes in the area. Watch my videos, you get quite an education, because I all the videos where I grow in Vegas, I show what I've done from the beginning, and you guys could see my, you know, tours that I do every season to show what I'm growing, and you will just want to grow some of the similar things, and you'll have similar results if you do similar gardening practices. You know, what Roman or I is doing is not magic. It's not like we got green thumbs or something. We've just learned over the school of hard knocks what works and what doesn't, and we just continue to do what works. Yes. And if something doesn't work, like I talked about earlier, you pull up all your zucchinis, even though they worked for a couple months, they're not working now, pull them out and start new and plant some new. And he shows that, you know, he just planted some new seedlings just the other day, and they're now popping up.
Really quick. Things I'm so surprised how fast things are popping up out here. So that's definitely encouragement. When you do throw some seeds down, you already see these seedlings coming up in 4 days. You're stoked. This is like amazing, you know? It just wants you to, you just want to keep going and keep planting more.
Yeah, and don't forget about, you know, inside, even if you don't have an outside like Roman does, like he has actually a nice large property with lots of space. And if this was my property, there's so many more space he could be growing in that I'd be growing in, and I'd fill up every possible space with some crops, like we talked to earlier about, maybe growing some moringa along some of the, you know, areas, and take out some of the oleanders and a whole bunch of other things. But yeah, there's always space to grow. And even if you don't have space, you know, there's community gardens here in Las Vegas. And even if you have an apartment or something, you could grow on your balcony. But even above and beyond that, I'd recommend what he's doing. And actually, we're using one of his lights right now to film this video, is his shells for growing microgreens and little baby plant starts. And you could grow sprouts inside your kitchen in just like a mason jar, or inside a nut milk bag, or inside a paint strainer bag. You know, I actually got some sprouts growing in my kitchen right now that I'll probably be harvesting tomorrow. And in just 2 days, they're finished, right? I'm growing some little baby buckwheat greens, or buckwheat sprouts, not buckwheat greens. They're just done in 2 days in the nice heat here. And so there's always a way to grow some food wherever you live. All right, so one of the last questions I have for you, Roman, is what's your biggest day at market? You know, in the peak of the springtime when you started in March, you know, things are really booming here. Right. Some of the pictures and some of the videos you have, and I'll post a link to your YouTube channel down below so you can check him out. You got some amazing growth here.
Yeah.
What was like your biggest day? Like, how much did you make, like, in all from like restaurants and market in one day?
You know, we're looking, you know, and this was in the beginning. So, you know, I was still kind of searching around for markets, but, you know, looking at $250.
$250 in 1 week just from working in your backyard,
that's
setting
like
your own
day.
Hours.
You know,
oh, one day.
Because that would be like farmer's market and going to a restaurant.
So that's one day, but that's a week's worth of income for you, basically, because you're only selling one day a week, right?
Yeah. Right, but I'm going into other farmers markets, though. There's another one that invited me that's down here on 11th Street. So, yeah, it's at Ferguson's, so that's a good one that's going to be coming up. It's two
so that's
days.
That's a new market. Mm-hmm. I don't know about that one. What is it?
It's really neat. It's like in this little alley right near 11th Street Records, and they call it the farmers market in the alley, so... they have different things, mostly artisan type things right now, but they invited me to come. There's already another farmer. He's up there on Gowan. They have a big farm.
Oh, yeah.
They already were there, and then they want me to come at the end of this month. So I'll be doing that one. Farmers markets start blowing up. You know, summer just slows down a lot. So
yeah.
Green Valley, you know, we've got this one here now, and then the Friday one. So I'll be pretty busy once the fall comes around.
Cool. Yeah, you gotta start ramping up your grow and grow more, because I think that's a challenge I've seen in your garden, right? I mean, it's 100 degree plus weather. It's not the easiest to grow, but things do grow here, and you know, definitely with some of the tips and I've given Roman, I think he'll be able to increase how much and the quantity he's growing, and then plus he has so much more land to expand into, and as long as he has buyers, he could continue to do that.
Absolutely. And I will eventually do that. You know, I'm gonna expand. I ran out of time because it got hot, you know, so I couldn't put more beds in. It was just way too hot. And to make the room and everything, it's a lot of preparation. I do 3 beds at one time, so, you know, it's a lot of work, you know, physical labor, so it has to be pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, the good thing is once you set it up once, that's all you got to do. So especially in the fall and the spring, you know, in the winter, if you're out working in the cold, set it all up so next year you'll be back in black. Exactly. All right.
And even the front yard, you know.
Yeah, you got a whole front yard to do too.
Mm-hmm, and that was in the plan too.
Wow, so. That'd be crazy. Mm-hmm. All right, so Roman, so are there any final last words you'd like to share with my viewers today about growing or anything that you've learned on your journey?
I think that this was a very healthy, for one, thing to do. And I really encourage people to definitely grow. You need to, especially in this climate. Yeah. We need to have more people growing. I'm so dumbfounded at why people are so intimidated by growing. It's possible. You can do this. And I want people to do this. And I want them to learn from what I'm doing, from what you're doing. So we just have to spread the word.
Absolutely. Yeah. So if you have any friends, people you know in Las Vegas or even other areas where people think you can't grow stuff because it's too hot, send them this video, send them my other videos, you know, growing in Las Vegas. It's really not that hard. You just got to learn the right practices. And whether you moved here from California, like we both did, or somewhere else in the country, right, you got to modify your gardening approach. You got to do things a little bit differently. Because let me tell you, it's a lot more easy to grow in California,
Yes. But
it's a lot more rewarding to grow here, because when you do grow something, you're like, yeah, I was doing that. And some things grow like gangbusters here. I could never get to grow in California. So anyways, Roman, before I go, actually, I want to present you with a gift that I brought you from my very garden here.
Too kind.
Yeah, no worries. The first is this guy. So we're bringing you a 100% green tree collar. And this is the most heat-tolerant tree collar. I know you already had one, and I don't know if that's a hybrid type or not, but here's a real one that you can plant. And this will, you know, my current one, I think I grew them in the winter. Mm-hmm. They stayed alive in the winter, of course. And now they're like, I just measured it the other day, they're 4 feet tall.
Whoa.
Just, you know, since Yes. The winter time. So keep this really nice. And once you got a nice plant going, you could take cuttings off it and make more.
My mix.
Yeah, in your mix. And you could, you know, harvest the little baby greens off it and get a whole row of these going. That's going to be amazing. Now, I will say that in the wintertime, these greens taste amazing. They're quite sweet because the coldness brings out the sweetness and causes the plant to create more sugars so that it can survive the frost. That being said, in the summertime, when the heat's beating down on these nice, large, more mature leaves, they get a lot more hot and spicy. But that's good because that's more anti-cancer activity in there for you guys.
Love it. I love perennials.
Yeah, perennial. And the other thing, this is not quite a perennial, but this is probably my best performing plant this year in the summertime. And look at this. I probably already posted the episode actually by the time this is coming out. But you guys wait, seeing the reflection of the light there. But you see all the roots on there? There's like basically three cuttings that I did on here. And this is, I swear to God, like maybe 5, maybe 6 days.
Wow.
And look at all these roots. After 2 days, the roots were like maybe about an inch long. And just a couple of days later, they blew up. Now, I put this kind of root mana stuff in my like cloning machine. But nonetheless, these are basically ready to get planted out into pots. And then, since I've been growing them only inside under lights, keep them under lights, and then maybe out, take them outside to temper them to the nice climate here. And these guys, the daddy and mommy plants are growing in 100% full sun, and I swear to God, they grow like a couple inches a day. So many greens to grow, another nice, really mild green for your mix. And these don't like below like 50 degrees, so they're going to be just in the summertime only. And in the winter, you're going to want to take cuttings and start the cuttings and then grow the cuttings indoors under your lighting. And then right after, the ground is not cold anymore, gets above 50, plant them all out, and then you're just going to have like a whole area of these guys. So once you got them forever. And this is the water spinach.
Beautiful. It's a beautiful plant.
Yeah, I mean, this just looks so cool. The roots just look so cool in there, and they just busted out so much. I'm so impressed with the water spinach.
Definitely. Brings a little bit more ornamental to the yard.
Yeah, a little bit ornamental and more variety. And that's what I would encourage you guys in Las Vegas or wherever you live, is to grow variety and seek out the plants that are native to climates where you live. So, you know, oftentimes I look for plants that grow in Africa and I grow in Southeast Asia, you know, that grow really well in the heat. And, you know, in many instances, they'll do well here. You know, sometimes some of the things from Southeast Asia that like the heat and the tropical weather don't do good here. But most of them don't really mind if it's a little bit drier. So, yeah. So, Roman, if somebody wants to buy your greens, visit you at the farmer's market, or come to your garden, check out your YouTube channel or your website, give everybody your information.
Very good. So, it's Sin City Farms, and I'm on Instagram as well at Sin City Farming. as well as YouTube, my YouTube channel, Sin City Farming, because I'm trying to kind of keep that, you know, perpetual motion going. And you can come over to my home. You can reach me from those sites and we can make an appointment. I'll give you my phone number and we'll text from there. And you're always welcome to stop by. And I'm currently at the farmers markets on Friday on 3rd Street. That's from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. And you can taste my greens over at Veggie Nation, the restaurant down here on Carson Street. So they're a wonderful restaurant. They're opening up a new restaurant in Henderson.
Oh, cool. That's awesome. Yeah, I haven't eaten there myself, but I've heard that it's pretty good.
Yes.
And I'm glad they're buying and supporting local farms.
Yes.
And I would encourage other restaurant owners in Las Vegas to also do that. And, you know, hopefully Roman could expand here to serve your guys' restaurants if there is the need for his local food. And local food is the best food.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, anyways, I'll post links to his all this stuff down below in the description of the video, so check that out. Also, be sure to thumbs this video up. If you liked it, thumbs it up. If I get a lot of thumbs ups, I'll come back and visit Roman another time of the year, maybe next season when his garden's really blown up, because
yes,
he's implemented a lot of suggestions I've given in this episode and actually even learned a lot more from just his own experience. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on any of my new and upcoming episodes. You never know where I'll show up or what kind of video I'll be making for you guys. About every 3 to 4 days, I got a new video coming out for you guys. Also, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, especially if you live here in Las Vegas. You know, the last couple of years, I have tons of videos that I filmed in my very garden, in my backyard here in Las Vegas. It's not really that hard to grow here. You just got to do the right things. And one of the worst things you could do is buy bag soil from your local big box store. Some of the crappiest stuff. I'm actually having some challenges with that right now and growing. And so that'll actually just make you fail from the get-go. Anyways, with that, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing.